Alright. All praises to the Heavenly Father, whose name is Yahweh, and his Son, Yahweh Shai. Double honors to the elders and apostles of Great Millstone. Salutations to all the brothers pushing this work in all sincerity and in truth. I'm the brother Yahya from the GMS Kingston Jamaica camp. Here again with another lesson, basically drafting up some spiritual perspectives on this article right here. Soldier shoots police constable allegedly caught in bed with his wife, right? So now, not to basically be too long in the article, I'm going to give a summary of what happened. So a JDF soldier basically caught his wife in sexual encounters with a police officer, right? And the JDF soldier ended up hitting the police officer in the face with his gun and shooting the police officer in the shoulder. The police officer ended up fleeing with his life intact, right? And a passerby picked up the officer and brought him to the hospital. So right now the soldier is basically in the position of being charged with wounding with intent and assault causing bodily harm, right? That is the speculation of the charges that could be brought upon the soldier. So now a spiritual perspective on this is that, number one, the police officer actually committed what you would call adultery because he's sleeping with another man's wife, right? And according to the laws of the Heavenly Father, according to Leviticus chapter 20, verse 10, it tells you what should happen in a scenario like this. Leviticus 20 and 10 says, "And the man that committed adultery with another man's wife, even he that committed adultery with his neighbor's wife, the adulterer and the adulteress shall surely be put to death." Right? So that is the law according to the Bible. What should happen if a man sleeps with another man's wife? Right? That is adultery. He shall surely be put to death, and his blood shall be upon him. Meaning that there won't be any form of judgment dish out for the person that puts this individual to death. You understand? So that is a case. Right? The other case is that due to what the soldier did, he's being basically brought up to charges. He might be brought up on charges of wounding with cause with intent, shooting with intent, right? Charged with wounding with intent and assault causing bodily harm, right? So now that shows the injustice of the society that we're living in right now. The scripture tells you in the book of Habakkuk chapter 1 verse 4, it tells us that, "Therefore the law is slack, and judgment doeth never go forth, for the wicked doeth compass about the righteous, therefore wrong judgment proceeded." Yeah, the wicked compass about the righteous, because all the individuals them that are in control of a legislative system right now, they are basically established by the wicked, which is the so-called white man, right? That's where they get the laws from. And the scripture in the book of Ecclesiastes chapter 10 verse 2 says, "As the judge of the people is, so are his officers. And what manner of man the ruler of the city is, such are all they that dwell therein." So we realize that the standards of the society is based on an immoral standard. It's not based on the laws and governance of the Heavenly Father. It's not based on the laws, statutes and judgments of the Heavenly Father. So the wrong judgment are proceed within this society. Right? So there, because what should happen is that if the JDF soldier went in and saw that man on his bed with his wife, that man should be put to death. That is the end all be all of that whole entire situation. The man and the woman should be put to death. Right? But no, that's not what is happening. What is happening is that the JDF soldier could be brought upon charges, right, of wounding with intent and assault causing bodily harm. Zin, and that is the speculative charges that he could be brought upon, right? The next thing again is that, how can you, in your right mind, right, go inside your house and see another man in your house that has access to a gun and not shoot him? He has access to a gun. If I go in my house and I see another man in my house, with I don't invite him there, I don't know, my wife never alert me, say, oh, this man has come over, you see, and I go inside the house and see a gun placed down somewhere in the house. This man get up, jump up, frightened, say, see me, right? And basically I scurry around. Me have to grab him, you see, and me have to shoot him because him have a gun. I don't know what cause him can have on my life, right? But the society is preying it as that the soldier man jealous and acted in a state of wrong because him end up shoot the police officer. He might have not known that he was a police officer. Him just basically act on what you call a crime of passion. See, in the spur of the moment, impulses arise. Him see him wife in compromising position, and to add insult to injuries, this individual have a gun. Them lucky say them never get a slugging at two of them. You understand? But just to show you the injustice that the society has, man. You understand? The scripture tells in the book of Isaiah chapter 59 verse 14, it says, and judgment is turned away backward, and justice standeth afar off. For truth is falling in the street, and equity cannot stand. Equity cannot enter. Yeah, truth faileth. And he that departed from evil maketh himself a prey. And the Lord saw it, and it displeased him that there was no judgment. So the Heavenly Father see these things right now, and it displeased the Heavenly Father because judgment now stand. The righteous standards of the law is not being executed. You understand? That's why when David prayed this prayer, and say, yo, O Lord God, to whom vengeance belongeth? Because we as the men of great millstone, and as prophets and ambassadors of the Heavenly Father, we always emphasize that we're living in a society that is based and run by the wicked elites. Them. So our defense is the Heavenly Father. See? Him are the one who are going to bring vengeance for us. So when we see these situations and these unjust situations happening, we understand it. We understand that, look here, these things are going to happen and they are going to play out, and we have to basically beg the Heavenly Father more and more to bring the vengeance come. Zin, O God, to whom vengeance belongeth, show thyself. So David asked Heavenly Father, say, oh, show yourself. Lift up thyself, thou judge of the earth, render a reward to the proud, because these individuals are proud. And then understand the policeman that brazenly go in another man's house, figure commit adultery with another man's wife. Them both proud. That's a proud hack, man, and that hack should be rewarded with death. Right? Lord, how long shall the wicked triumph? How long shall they utter and speak hard things, and all the workers of iniquity boast themselves? Because this state of idolatry that the world is in right now, that is all the wicked boast themselves in. They boast themselves in wickedness and abomination. Understand? And I can guarantee, say, yo, you can imagine how the soldier did attack, the police officer was basically speaking to him comrades them, or him fellow colleagues, about how him are going to mash up a JDF soldier wife in a bed. You can imagine the conversation that was taking place. And that was a proud talk. You understand? But the Heavenly Father not asleep. The Heavenly Father take note of all of these things, and him coming to recompense judgment upon this land. You understand? Because we see the injustice, we see the iniquity and abomination that is spreading, and the immoral standards of the heads of government. Zimmy, we see it. You understand? And every father basically going to make a speedy riddance of all of what is happening, man. You understand? You can check out the video that was done by my brother, James 5 Precept. He did a video on it as well. And my brother James Hope and Prayer, he also did a video on it. Two beautiful lessons that basically took the lesson from a different handle, right? That took it from different handles. I'm just taking it from the handle of injustice that is basically being promoted in the land. You understand? So you can watch those two videos and get a broader perspective of a spiritual perspective of what happened. You understand? So I hope that this lesson was edifying unto the elect of the nation of Israel. I want to say Kalalal, Yahweh, Ba'ashem, Yahushai, Ba'ashem, Rakar, Kadash, Baba, honors to the elders and apostles of Great Millstone, and salutations to all the brothers that's pushing this word in our sincerity and in truth. Shalom.